any controlled environment. This is just like any room anybody can build out there to raise it. It would help any type of drama team coming in here to rear them and allow us multiply. It means any security is here and actually be multiplied very easily, be released. It's just very close to the normal environment. We still have not entered the key enclosure. For example, we have brought in some material that we found out there in the field actually attacking some insects, some plants, some host plants. And those host plants hang here. We start pupating, you can see the pupas here. We now identify them so that we can advise our stakeholders, our farmers, our commercial farmers on how to control this. So this material comes inside here and we are able to hear that. When we are doing very manipulative experiments that require very slight changes, plus minus one of a degree of a humidity, we cannot be able to do it in a big room like this. To do that, a 2.8 million body of insect clearing chamber has actually been purchased by KEFRI. This is a chamber that can be able to set the temperatures that you want here, plus minus 1 degree, and be able to put the humidity that you want, plus minus 5 degrees, and also be able to put the photo period. How many hours darkness, how many hours light. And you are able to put it here, and that insect once is there here, you can now be able to know how long it is actually going to take to develop what it contains and all that. This is a facility that we call the insect clearing chamber that is actually set by our technicians and we are able to run it without any major problem. Very particular areas are given. These are the methods that we actually put in place so that the rearing system can be developed. So this is a facility that is actually very, very important, which was purchased in a last allocation at a 2.8 million and is very important. When materials come out from there, then what we actually get is material that must be put in bags that are well marked and are brought under minus 80 degrees chest freezer. That is here, and that material comes in here, and when it comes in here, it is cooled at minus 80 for 14 days. Everything dies at that level. And from there we can incinerate, and that record is actually good. It shows no insect will be able to escape out of this place. So these are facilities that we have. And it stays here so that any other facility that is here, then they are good. So the benches you see here are actually for air.
So what we are doing here basically is getting the pest, because this is what we are going to use for rearing the parasitoid. It's a larval parasitoid, lays its eggs inside the larvae of armyworm, therefore bringing to an end its life, so that it doesn't progress to another. So we have all the stages of the armyworm here, and as of now we are just awaiting the arrival of the parasitoid. We have already given certificate for import from KEFRI, so hopefully later this month or early in January, it will be here. We're hoping to.
We're preparing its food.
Yeah, so this is how we feed the armyworm. There are different ways of feeding it, but this is the best because we want to weigh it individually, so that when the parasitoid comes, we can know who was infected, who was not, who was parasitized, and who was not parasitized. Mm-hmm. So that the major interest is those that are parasitized. Yeah.
So this is the kind of thing we are currently acclimatizing, so that by next week but one, the first exotic biological agent will be arriving, and we expect in 6 months we should be helping this country control this very serious threat in forestry, in agriculture. And then there you are. This facility is not limited to agriculture. We will expand it to cover people. These are the rearing benches that I talked about, and these benches have been put in a way that if you want to lower this light, you can lower it. Because light is a very important aspect in rearing of insects.